from the Technical University of Denmark, and I want to show you how we work with genome editing here in our labs. First of all, when it comes to GMOs, we have very...
Carl!
What are you doing here?
Sorry to interrupt you. Yeah, so good to see you too. I just couldn't wait to inform you about the new study that's been released from the European Commission on the new genome technologies.
That fits quite well. I was just talking about genome editing.
Perfect. Yeah, but I just wanted to follow up on that study, and in that regard, I have bought you some food.
Okay, a cauliflower. That's a bit weird. Okay, let's see where this is going.
And a maize.
Maize, okay.
Maybe you have a recipe in mind?
Sure. Cauliflower and maize always go good together.
What about a soy drink?
A soy drink, I will take that one. I've been getting onto that lately as a good replacement for milk if you are worried about the environmental effects of dairy farms.
Definitely. But I want to challenge you, because can you tell me if these are GMOs just by looking at them?
Yeah, from just looking at them, I think it's quite hard. Now that I think about it, I'm afraid I couldn't even tell you how they are regulated here in the supermarkets in Denmark, or the EU for that matter.
I can tell you a bit about that. So the GMO laws that are applying were enacted in 2001 by the European Commission. And since then, new technologies have developed, and they are regulated the same way as the old ones. So there's been a push in the EU to revise the current laws, and that is what the new study is all about.
Yes, so, but also outside of the lab, I might see more GMOs, for example, in the supermarket, you're saying?
Yeah, could be, but would you even eat a GM crop if you found one in the supermarket?
I think so, yes, I think I would try one. What about you, would you?
I'd rather not eat a GM crop if I had the choice.
Okay, that's fair. But maybe you can tell me now, is any one of those items a GMO here, or all of them?
I guess we have to find out.